what I do now. I come home, all I do is just drive around all the time. Just want to show you now up here, and it's like the best view in Sligo. It's amazing. It's my favourite view in Sligo. The lake, like,
have you ever taken Gillian up here for a romantic snog?
A couple of times, yeah.
Yeah.
You can say, no, we always drive up here just to drive and see it, because it's such a beautiful view.
That's stunning view. It's a lot nicer than I thought it would be.
Oh, Sligo's amazing, honestly. There's so many good views. This is just breathtaking, this view. Yeah.
Wow.
Get a better angle on it.
It's one of the best views in Ireland.
It actually is. I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised if it is. It's just such an unbelievable view. It's all Loch Gillan. It's Beasy's Island, it's called. It's a pub and town called Beasy's. It's named after that.
Would you
if it's a really hot day, like the water's really blue, it's just like amazing. Fairness, this isn't the best day probably to see it, but it's got all the mountains and like forestry, like Canada or something over there. So I always come up here, every time I come home, always. Drive up here just to see it, drive around it. It's a really cool road, this is really kind of sharp bends on it and stuff. This is the holy well now, this is like a place
where
you can pray and stuff. And
would you ever pray yourself?
Totally.
Yeah?
All the time when I come home, I always go in there with Mum. My Mum loves this place, one of her favourite places. Let's have a little tea there. I'll always look back as I walk away. Stand me with the last of eternity. Mum loves coming out here. Loves it. Nice. It'll be finished, I'd say hopefully around Christmas time.
You're hoping to be in for Christmas, yeah?
Hopefully, yeah, I'd like to be, but it's got to do all the stone. I've got, like, see the cut stone here?
Yeah.
You've got to put that on a whole house, and that's going to take months. So it might be a bit after Christmas, but... Do you want to go into it?
Yeah, let's go and have a look, yeah.
It's on, like, a big site. It's on, like, 12 acres.
Okay, there's going to be, like, massive big steps leading up into this.
Yeah, that's all going to be steps, patio, all that there, and there'll be steps to be the door. The whole door is, like, there, and it's all glass to the roof. So you can see the chandelier balcony come up the drive and see it all lit up. See it? It's all a bit of a wreck at the moment. This is the best room in the house.
Is this going to be like the living room here?
No, this is the dining room.
The dining room?
Two-story dining room.
Oh my goodness.
Goes up two stories. Be like a big long table there.
Two-story dining room.
Yeah, it's cool actually, it's lovely. If you steps down into this, and there's this room, that's like a music room and it's all glass there as well. Like two big giant glass windows.
So what do you mean by music room?
Grand piano, just stuck in it. Just a grand piano and that's it.
Can you play the piano?
No. My sisters can. I know good at it though.
So they'll get good use out of it?
Huh? Yeah. This is all connected, that goes. This is the snooker room. There's one room I had to have in it.
Really?
The snooker table, yeah. I had to have a snooker
table. Are you a bit of a snooker fan?
Oh, stop. I love snooker.
Really?
Absolutely love it. Highest break. 46 actually I got once. That was a bit of a fluke. I usually get like 15, or I might just get like 3 or 4 balls in, and that's it then.
How many bedrooms?
There, lads. There's seven.
Seven bedrooms?
Seven, eight actually, because there's stuff upstairs as well. They're all en suite. No, that one isn't. Most of them are en suite.
What do your mum and dad make of all of this? This is like every parent's dream, isn't it?
Any mum would be. Like, all our mums and dads are proud of us. Five of us, like, we've all stayed fairly sane, and we've all kind of stayed normal, which is really good, and which is sometimes really weird for some bands with the success we've had, I suppose. But just in general, we're just glad to be doing it. I'm proud of it. I mean, our parents are proud of us. And it's great to see them like at the concerts and singing up the songs, and us singing down to them, pointing down to them and stuff. And it's just a great feeling. Like, it's brilliant. Like, it's a feeling I've always wanted, and I have it now. And it's the one at the end, you know what I mean? Taking the easy way out. It's actually very quiet out there.
you ever tempted just to, with the money that you've got now and this lovely house and everything, you ever tempted just to say, I really can't be bothered going on another tour, let's just call it a day now, you've had success?
But it's not about that, it's not about money, do you know what I mean? It's not, obviously money makes like it, might make it easier if you want to buy something, but that's all money is, like money makes things easier to buy, do you know what I mean? It doesn't make you happier, necessarily. But like it's not about just money, it's a nice thing to have it, but it's more about singing for me, do you know what I mean? I love singing, it's what I've always wanted to do, have a mic in my hand and make a living out of it, obviously. It is important, we wouldn't do it for free, because then we wouldn't be making a living, do you know what I mean? But we have been lucky on that side of things, in fairness. But it is about the singing, it's about getting up on stage, singing out to like 20,000 people, there's no better feeling like. Yeah, Sam, if you go Fimber so in the Jeep. Yeah, I know where we're going, yeah, over the back way, yeah. No, go through Oakfield and go down and turn off to Trantill. Go over out by St. Mary's. Turn down by the dairy. Get totally out of town. Right. Change of plan. I don't know, I can't imagine why, because helicopters land here all the time. So unless it's, I don't really know much about helicopters, as in fuel and weight and all that kind of stuff, so.
So basically, you're meant to be getting a helicopter to the gig from here, but what the pilots told you that you can't land because there's not enough space.
Yeah, but there's like acres and acres of land, like, you can't. Anyway, he said it's something to do with fuel, it's because he's fully fueled up and taken off. He just said safety is the best thing to have, like an open space, but I don't know.
This is putting the pressure on you now, because it's not getting long till you need to be down.
I know, and we need to get to the airport straight away, yeah, it is, because I gotta do a lot of stuff when I get down there to sort out, because we're changing the kind of format of the show, the beginning and the end. And we need to make sure it's perfect, you know what I mean? So, this on
the... So it's time to get a little bit tense, a little bit nervous, maybe?
Not nervous, I just want to kind of get there. Everybody's looking for that something. One thing that makes it all complete. You find it in strange places. Places you never knew it could be. I'm finding in the face of the
ultimate lifestyle you need to have. You've seen the amazing house, you've got the whole stable, and now you're getting a helicopter to your back biggest gig ever.
Pretty cool, it's like just flying over Sligo now. This is the best view I've ever actually had. It's like never flown over in a helicopter.